In this video, guys, we will be changing the window mechanism from my Audi project car, the A4, of course, 1.8 turbo. So make sure you watch the whole video and leave a thumbs up. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. What is up? Today we will be changing the window mechanism. It's necessary because I bought this car and you can see from the outside already it has some wood in there, some pins, so the window doesn't fall down. Now the car salesman said to me, probably on the inside the mechanism is broken, so when you pick the wood out the window will fall down. Well, that's something we cannot have. So I have a new window mechanism. It's in plastic so far, but to do this we need to unlock the car first, of course. We need to take the whole inside out of there and then unbolt everything, and then the rubbers from this side until this side, you can see the line here, yeah, and then you can take this whole thing out. So yeah, we have quite a job to do, so might as well just get started. I will be mostly sitting here. We're gonna need some Torx screwdrivers. We're gonna need a cross head, or how they say in America, a Phillips screw. And we're gonna need a flathead. Now guys, I know when I do this, this is wrong. You have special tools to do that, but I don't have them and I don't want to buy them just for this one day. So I just use my screwdriver. So please, please don't put that in the comments, okay? But now the first thing we have to do is to make sure the window doesn't fall down. Now I assume when we take this thing out, the wood will fall loose, and perhaps the worst case scenario is that the window falls in and shatters. To prevent that, we're gonna tape it. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this rubber right here, this one, should not come off. So we're just gonna tape it. It's easier to wash out some glue from the tape than to replace an entire window because it's shattered. So let's do that. Now on most cars this entire handling is pretty much the same. If you want to change the inside and from the window mechanism, it's pretty basic stuff. It's on most cars pretty much the same. Not exactly this. It has some similarities, and if you can do this on an Audi A4, then you can do it on any car basically, because from what I have seen on the internet, this is the most difficult one to tear apart. If you don't believe I am right, and if you have another car which you believe is more difficult, let me know in the comments, you guys. I'm gonna tape it real good because, well, better safe than sorry. Yes. Ah, maybe another one. And I don't even know if I have to take this rubber on the outside off. Maybe I will, maybe I don't. But we'll see. This is about as far as we get, as we can go. Just let it go. Now, first things first. We take the crap out. My OBD11 car diagnostic tool, and for whatever reason a pen. Now first there is a little plastic right here under the door handle, so we just click it out like that. It's all sticky and used and ill. So now we can get to a screw or two there. Yeah, that is correct. I can see two screws. And now we have to take this one loose. Start on the inside because let me show you. The outside just goes like this, you know, you just slide it in and slide it out. Awful. So yeah, this thing is hard plastic. I have seen videos that these pins stay in, but don't worry, you can just take them out. Now we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. We need to unbolt those, and well, when we did that, there are two in here. I don't believe, yes, there is one down here, only one, right? And when that is done, you can take the entire mechanism out, the inside of this. So let's get to it. Now we have two in here. Yeah, they're pretty deep. I'm gonna need a different screwdriver. Well, maybe. Maybe I can do it like this. Nope. I need a smaller and longer screwdriver. Alright guys, I'm picking out the big guns. So, I even lose my coat because it's warm today. Which is why it's an ideal day to do this. So let's go. And now it would seem one here. Alright guys, so it's completely loose. We have the bolts out here, the screws I would say. Two here and one here. I mean, it's still in, but let me show you in a little bit. Also, I clicked it loose by accident, and now what we do is we lift it up a little bit and take it out. Now one problem exists, the little woody things. So well, let's pray. Yep, I was afraid of. Just wiggle it a little bit. Just wiggle it a little bit. Oy, oy, oy. Yep, there we go. Alright. It's loose. Now, if you look from the inside. Yeah, from the inside, yeah. We have to unclip this one. And just lift it a little bit. So, that was the door handle. So, now. Now we have this side loose, okay? So now what we have to do is to make sure the electronic stuff goes out, yeah? Now, if I'm not mistaken, this should go out like that. Ah, that's great, one side is broken. But no matter, now, this one should go out like that. Yeah. And we have this one. It should come out like that. Alright guys, so we disconnected all the electrical wiring. Which is nice, eh? So now we take off the motor and the computer and the speaker box. So basically there are only three screws for this motor, and they're pretty loosey-loosey, lefty-loosey. You can see them coming out. Now you have to keep remembering and have to keep in mind where what screw was. Now how do you do that best? By not losing them. And to put them back in. So when this comes out, let me show you. Let me show you. No, 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 no. Let me show you, okay? So 1, 2, 3. Always check if the screws and bolts are always the same size. In this case, they are. Now, this should come popping off. Now, what you have here, this is the central computer for this door. It's Audi, it has the numbers on it and everything, and this is your motor for the window, yeah? So this right here, this inside is the window mechanism. So yeah, it's gonna be fun. So we have to remember that this one goes on like that, yeah? Now we put back the screws. Now, be very careful with this thing, because when this breaks, you have no window, you have no door clink, you have nothing. So you have to remember that. Okay, now we put this in a safe place. Next step is the speaker, which is bolted with the screws. This one comes off quite easily. Now, what we're gonna see now is something special, you guys. Because right there, I don't know, can you see it? Can you see it? Right there, this piece is the window mechanism. I can already see that the wiring, it has steel cables running through, which makes the window go up and down, and I already can see that's pretty banged up. That is pretty banged up. So yeah, it's only logical it doesn't work. What do we have to do now? We're gonna push this in, which is why I have brought my good friend. Here we are. What a pump tongue. So yeah, you all know the meaning of it. Now what you do is push these clips in, yeah? Clippy clippy! There. Loosey loosey, yeah? Okay, so the next step is to pull this entire thing off. It's glued on. But as you can see on here, on these occasions, and this part, it was already loose once. So there's no shame in destroying it, because it's not my favorite car, and well, what does it actually do? Not much. I mean, it does something. It's meant to withhold the sounds from outside, but yeah. You know, oh, this is sticky glue, man. Yeah, this is one sticky mess. I am really impressed. But you will not win from the Dutch mic. Okay, so now, what do me I see, eh? We can see all the interior parts. We can see this kind of stuff right here. Now, we have to make everything loose. These big bolts have to go on the inside. Here are big bolts. Big bolts everywhere, man. And then, this entire part. Yeah, you can see. Look, 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 look here, look here. The window is supposed to be in this thing, so you can do the window up and down, up and down, up and down. So yeah, basically when the tape lets go, well, we're a long way from home. So yeah, let's work this out. Let me look up some more info, some more intel, you know, and then get to it. All right guys, so we have to take this rubber off. all the way down here. We have to take that one out and we have to pull this weather resistant thing out. So this pops right out. That is a-okay. Oh, it's a little rusty in there. That's not a problem. Oh yeah, we have to pull that one out because there should be a screw there somewhere, I'm guessing. And oh, we cannot lose this one. So now we have to pull this rubber out. It is sad that you just pull it out with a now, okay, now that one is loose. As you can see, we only need to make it loose until here because the rest of the door is going to come out. So take that one out, I guess. Yep, there we go. This one is loose. So let us see what we have to do next, because I am doing this. I never done this before. This is as mechanical as it gets. So I do use YouTube videos. I only hope you watch me for your entertainment. Alright guys, once again we have the flathead screwdriver, if you will, or the minus plus. So now we have to take this little protector, the plastic, out here, and then we will be unscrewing those bolts, which should be fun because it's all tidy. Okay, so ta-da! That worked out really well. It's all clicked, so yeah. Now, let's go. We have to unbolt this one and unbolt that one. Obviously, because this is from the window regulator. Now, I'm not expecting it to go loose as easy. Well, maybe I was wrong. This one looked the most damaged. But it's coming out, well, I wanted to say perfect, but that's not the word. Alright guys, so I have watched and I have seen that highly likely the window is going to be put down still by these woody things, because there's nothing more we have to do here. Now we have to unbolt the big bolts, make this one go in, which is not that hard. On that side you have another two bolts, and we have to do something here, but let's do one step at a time. I already make them a little loose, but well, wasn't actually a problem because it's all loosey-loosey. You can see how easy it turns.
No.
Whoa. Hallelujah. Now. Oh, that is no. I don't know what that was. Let's pretend that did not happen, okay? So now basically, technically, yep, you can see this is fun. I want to run away.
I want to run away real bad, because I have no idea what I'm doing. But hey, the weather is good, and due to Corona we can't go anywhere, so might as well do this. So now what we have to do is to put the electric wiring all back in. So it seems like an easy job. It really isn't. Now we have cable here. Oh. Pretty basic stuff, you know, doing it all day. There we go. Okay, so this is all good. There we go. Now that is all loose. Assuming this one has to go in as well. And I don't know why, but I'm assuming that one is two and that one is two. So now something exciting is going to happen, you guys, because this part has to go, this, this looks so not comfy. Why is this stuck? Ah, of course, it's glued. All right, guys, moment of truth. We're gonna lift this entire thing out. I hope you can see it. Put it down there and then we will grab you with us. So now we have to easy. Yeah, lift it, lift it, lift it. Yep, yep, lift it. Hold on, hold on, hold on. There we go. Now it should be a piece of cake. Oh shit. Man, oh man, oh man. There we go. Going up. Okay, now. It's not that heavy.
Stuck here.
Yeah, I see it.
I have to show that.
Okay, wait a minute. It's still stuck. Right there.
Okay.
Yeah, that's awesome. No, no, no. Wait, 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 wait. Waity, waity. Out. Ah, can you grab it here? Yeah? Because now, okay, here we go. Okay, easy now, easy. Whoop, whoop. Oh, 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 moment. Come on. Okay, now we have to put it like that. Yep, awesome, guys, awesome. Now, what we have to do, we have the new parts here. So let me first show you how an electric window works. As you know, on this part here comes the motor. When you want the window go up, this thing turns. This is a wheel which pulls this lever, this cable, which makes this window go up. Well, normally it is attached, the window is attached to this and it will go up and down. This is pretty basic, pretty simple. So guys, here it is. Now I believe we have a problem. This is which why I already pulled the tape off, because here is a bolt we need to unscrew And we have to unscrew this bolt, I believe. So, this means we have to let the window down.
There we go.
This one goes in here. And this one goes on the other side, of course, you know.
There we go.
It's loose! Now, what I'm gonna do is, for safety measures, take the window out entirely. As you might have seen, it's already loosey. So,
they see me rolling, they hate them.
Oh. Let's not do that. Let's put this somewhere where it's safe. What we do is just replace this. This is easy peasy lemon squeezy. There was almost one bolt that didn't want to go. But it was almost. So now we can take this one away from here. Yes. Now we put the new one. Yeah, like that. Now I don't know. Yeah, no, this is the right way. This is the way to go, my friend. My friends. And what we do is we just start to screw it all in. You don't want to make it too tight just yet. This one goes in here. I'm gonna need Mandy's help for this for just a second, so when you get back this thing will be far off ready. So. Alright guys, so it's see-through. No, the window is down there, it's in. What we're gonna do now is Mandy and I am gonna rework everything we've done just to build it up again. I'm not gonna film that because, well, you'll see how it goes apart, and now we are just putting it together in the same exact way, so that is not really interesting. But I'm coming back to you when we are going to test it for the first time, but for now we have to focus on rebuilding. So I will see you in a short bit. As you can hear, the car runs. We haven't put the window up yet, so this is gonna be the first time. But before we do that, leave a like if you like this video, because when this thing breaks, I know you're gonna like it, because you're all sadists like me. But yeah. Oh, ah, fuck yeah. Ay, 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 ay! The automatic program works. Unfortunately, the left or the right side, passenger side works nothing. But at least we can go to McDonald's again. That's awesome. That's smooth. That's awesome. We only need to clean it a little bit because the new mechanism was in grease of some kind. So yeah, we're gonna clean up now and bring the shit in and well, maybe some McDonald's. But anyway, if you like this video, make sure you do a thumbs up and actually like it. Make sure you subscribe here down below for more of this kind of funny content you can find everywhere but not as funny as me. So yeah, I will be doing live videos more because, well, basically I just like them. I like them very much. I am saving up for a new computer, which will be perfect. Yeah, that's all the news I can get for you today. So subscribe, like, and share. See you later, guys.